Hey folks, Isaac Weintraub here. We are standing here on the first tee of my very own golf course. I am lucky enough to be quarantining on a property that's a few acres, and I made a little golf course here. We're standing here on the first tee. You can see some of the tee markers or small sticks, which you can see right here over my left shoulder. I feel like Vanna White. Very understated. You know, but going with the natural land, you can see here that the tee box we're dealing with is a lot of pine needles, probably mostly fir needles, actually. We've got some cedar trees above, and then we've got some moss, too, and there's a little bit of grass in there. The first hole here is it's about 80 yards, and it's a risk-reward hole. You know, it's pins cut back left today. We've got plenty of room to the right. Pond on the left, actually, and let's take a look at it. We got a pond on our left and a slope on the right. You're gonna want to avoid that pond. As you approach the green here, you can see the cup is cut back left here. It's a par three here, and two is an option. It's a short hole, 80 yards. You can bounce one up. The green's actually running pretty fast. It's a quick screen on the course, and you know, a birdie here is a great way to start your round. Let's check out number two.
So we're here on the second hole here on Baker Road. And they've actually decided in recent days to combine the second and third holes into one hole. The second hole originally was called Low. It was a very short hole. You can actually still see the remnants of the green in the cup just over my left shoulder. And then I believe the third hole was called Curve. And so they've actually combined the two holes now into a hole called Low Curve. And again, it's about a 75-yard hole. You can't go quite straight up because you've got a lot of trees in the way. But three, it's a par three as well. And three on this hole is a great score. Why don't we go check it out? Work is here. As you can see here, we've got everything sloping hard to the right. You can see on your right here, you've got the remnants of the old second green. That green's actually not in use there, but the cup there is actually still cut. See if I can not fall. As we go through this area here, you can see this is the reason why the hole was called Low. You have to keep it low below all of these trees here. You can go high, but it's a big risk. On the left, we've got a sand pile here that actually comes into play more on the third hole. And as you come down here towards the road, you can see the cup is cut really close to this berm. There's a lot going on in this hole. As I said before, you don't want to go long. You've got road, which is OB, and you've got a berm right in front of you here, so you've only got about 8 to 10 feet beyond that cup. Again, three here on the second hole is a wonderful score.
All right, I'm crouching here on the third tee box here. This hole is called Cruzando, which means crossing. There's actually two areas of the hole that you have to cross over. One, if we stand up here, is this large sand pit. You don't really want to go into that. That is a lot of trouble. And with the recent rains up here, it's become a bit of a mud pit. So once you go in there, you know, you can take a drop, we'll call it a penalty area. I like to get in there and try to play it just because, you know, it's golf. After that, we'll cross the road up there, which I don't know if you can see, we'll try to raise this up a little bit. And you can see the hole way in the distance, just on the right-hand side here. It's a slight dogleg right and you have to keep it really low. And again, you've got an opportunity to make birdie here, but three is still a great score. So far, we've got three par threes. Let's go take a look at this hole. From this angle, you get a much better view. You've got the tee box here on number three. And we've got these sand pits that you're going to have to cross over. It's a pretty deep sand pit. The other crossing on this hole is the driveway. We'll call it a road for the sake of this golf course. But you do get a drop off of this, fortunately. Unfortunately, you'll have to drop in this treed area. As you can see here, we've got the green on the left under this hanging arbutus tree. And you got to be really careful here because we've got OB right, driveway to the right, and a lot of trouble up here. You can lose your ball quickly in here. So again, three is a great score on this hole, a par three, and that's number three. All right, folks, we're here on the fourth tee box. The fourth tee box actually shares space with the third green, much like a lot of classic golf courses. The two are actually the same space. We're right underneath this wonderful arbutus tree. You can see this curvy structure. It's very nice. And as you go up here, it's a really tight shoot right up the middle to the green up there. You can see you kind of have to thread it through. Everything's sloping hard to the left. This hole is called Metal, and you're about to find out why.
As you come out of the forest here, which could capture your ball, you'll see you've got a pretty wide fairway here with everything sloping to the left. Now the prudent play is just to play your first shot into this fairway. You've got a power pole to contend with, and then you've got the road, which you do get a drop off that road. So the best play here would be to play the ball left and then chip up towards the cup. This area here on the right is a no-go. In addition to one of the reasons why this hole is called Metal is because, well, first of all, it tests your metal. Second of all, when the designers were making the golf course, they actually ran out of PVC pipe and they actually installed the cup, which is metal. It's the only one on the course. It's a unique feature here. Again, 3 is a great score here. Let's go check out the final hole, a risk reward hole over the pond. All right, folks, we're here on the 5th tee box here, and this hole is aptly named Decision, or in Espanol, Decision. The reason for the name of the hole is obvious. You've got a very short pitch of 35 to 40 yards over the pond. Eventually, I'll show you where the cup is. Or if you feel better about it, you can play off to the left towards my cottage, play off the hill, have a really good chance at birdie, and likely a guaranteed 3. If you go this way, well, I've had a couple near hole-in-ones, but I've also had a couple of balls that got wet. Let's go check out this hole. It's a great finishing hole here at this golf course. Okay, we're just leaving the 5th tee box here. We're gonna go check out this hole. We've got to contend with a couple of gopher holes, what looks like gopher holes here, although I thought it was too cold for gophers in this area of the world. As we're going here, we're actually crossing over the first green and the first fairway. So these two holes actually share a fairway. Not very busy out here on a normal basis. We've got the cottage on the left. As you can see here, this is a very large slope. This is the prudent play. And as we come around the corner of this bend here, you'll actually see the cup on the 5th green. It's very well placed and hidden. As we look back towards the tee, you can see that the entire hole, if you choose to do so, is all carry. As we said before, it's a high risk, high reward, or you can take it easy and play towards home. This golf course is becoming better and better by the day, and we can't wait to see you out here. Take care from Quarantine Life. All right, everyone. We just finished playing the golf course here. You got a nice tour of it. I've been playing it, you know, at least twice a day. Really good exercise here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna show you the post-round area. This is called a mossy knoll. And if you just hang with me here for a second, I'll show you. It's a nice spot for a couple minutes of meditation and solitude. And we gotta climb up this hill here a little bit. Let me show you what we're looking at. As we climb up this hill, you can see that there's moss everywhere. It's almost like a bit of a fairyland here. We've got mossy covered rocks. And we've created a spot to sort of sit, you know, perhaps have a beverage, drink some water. We're going up this hill through a couple of rose bushes. As you can see here, this is sort of the entrance to what we would call the 6th hole. It was formerly called the 7th hole, but this golf course actually became 6 holes very recently. And as you can see here, we've got our oasis. It's a mossy knoll. You can relax. We've got a couple of features here made by some of our younger stars that have come through here. And it's a wonderful place to sit. All right, folks, you've seen the golf course, you've seen the mossy knoll, you've seen the meditation spot. You know, a round of golf out here, if you're playing fast and playing well, could take, you know, 20 to 25 minutes, leaving yourself with plenty of time for meditation. You know, depending on how large your group is, it could take up to an hour. And the great news is there's actually no pace of play policy out here, which is really nice, which means that you actually go at your own pace, which is sort of important, I've found. Playing golf, living life at your own pace. All right, folks. It's been great. Thanks for tuning in. And I'm headed to the first tee. I don't know about you. I want to do it again.